So now let's talk about language. How many language can you speak?
I can speak three languages, which are English, Hindi, and Punjabi. So I use those English, sorry, Hindi and Punjabi when I meet an elderly person who do not understand the English language. So it is easy to communicate if a person know more than one language.
How useful will English be to you in your future?
So English is an universal language, so it is most of it is spoken by majority of the community all over the world. So if I start a business or I started doing a job, so if I meet another a person who is belongs to another country or I visit another country, so I can definitely use my English speaking English abilities and communicate with them very easily.
What do you remember about learning language at school?
Okay, there are many languages which we learn in the school. I remember learning English when we were taught for the sentences, verbs, and tenses, which one we should use, and all that stuff.
What do you think would be the hardest language for you to learn?
I think I only know three languages, so apart from that, I think most of the language will be difficult because obviously I do not have any access or any learning abilities for that. I have to start from the scratch to learn those items, so it will be everything will be new for me.
Okay, so now I'll give you a prompt and you'll have 1 minute to prepare yourself, and then you have to describe your website that you bought something from in 1 to 2 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, so let's start. So, are you ready?
Okay, yeah.
Please start.
Nowadays, there are numerous websites which are available, and people can buy anything from whenever they go online. So, the website I'm going to talk about is Kmart.com. In that website, you can find all kind of clothing for men, women, and kids as well. And also, there are many things available such as homeware, fitness equipments, bags, makeup, and so on. And I visited this website to buy clothes for my daughter, and I bought many clothes for her. And there I saw that there is wide range of clothing available, so you can choose any of them, whichever you like, in different colors. So the good thing was for the website was it is more mobile friendly, so you do not have to open your laptop and buy the things. And also they were delivering the goods for free if it's over the $50. And also there are a size chart were available, so you will not have to worry about it will come on different size or different color. And also they mentioned the discounts as well, so which is good. If you buy one, the another one will be free. And first of all, I couldn't understand how to use that website, but by the time I spent few minutes on that, I got an understanding like how it works. The experience on this website was very good, and it is very easy. And nowadays, majority of the people buy online things online because most of them are busy at work or they are studying full time. So it is the website's things. Made this easy that everyone can have the necessary things on time, as they also provide the next day delivery, or you can pick up on the spot, and it is called click and collect, so it is very easy for a human being.
Okay, so now let's talk about online shopping. What kind of things do people in your country often buy from online shops?
Yeah, majority of the people they like to buy things online, which can be obviously bags, makeup products, and also clothing. clothing is, I think, a very good thing which they can buy. And most of the youngsters, they prefer to do the online shopping rather than the old people. Old people still want to buy, visit the shops and buy the goods.
Okay. Why do you think online shopping has become so popular nowadays?
As I mentioned, most of the people are busy working and a few of them are busy in studying, doing their assignments. And also this is more convenient. And this is the another most prominent benefit of online shopping. So the convenience of the buying goods online is very good. And people, they do not have to worry. They have to go there and spend this much time. They just go to the website and choose the product. The product will arrive at your home by the next day.
Okay. What are some possible disadvantages of buying things from online shops?
Okay. Disadvantage of buying things online is sometimes the wrong sizes of the dresses or clothes. So because we can't wear them and try it on the same time because it's online, and you can't feel the texture of the clothes. Like sometimes a person want to wear cotton clothes, but it comes in different texture. And also sometimes if it's for example a product for home wear, such as a crockery or something, they broke in the transit. So sometimes the delivery guys, they do not put more attention and they just throw the item in front of the gate. So they broke, and this is the another disadvantage. Apart from that, sometimes the goods, they do not come as we expected. Like we expect something else. I remember when I bought a dress from online store, and when it reached at home, it was looking totally different. The design was totally different. Sometimes what they show on the website is different, and what you receive, it's totally different.
Okay, now let's talk about culture of consumerism. Why do many people today keep buying things which they don't need?
I think majority of the people, they buy those things which they don't even need, just to show that they have more and more money, just to show off. That's the only reason. I know one friend who was rich, and she used to buy a lot of things without any reason.
Okay. Do you believe the benefits of a consumer society outweigh the disadvantages?
There are many benefits of the consumer society, such as people pay taxes, so which is good for the customer, good for the governments, and as they can have the financials. But I feel like there are many disadvantages, because it creates the imbalance between the communities. Like rich people are getting richer and poor people are getting poorer. Most of the time, wealthy people, they give preference to the luxury products, and also the large companies will only get the benefit from that, because when rich people buy expensive products, the only benefit goes to the large companies as it increases their sales. And also the rich people, they do not like the low quality products, so the ordinary people will not be able to sell their goods and will not get any of the benefits.
Okay, so how possible is it to avoid the culture of consumerism?
I think it is not that possible, but few of the people, they nowadays like to buy the things which are not the necessity, and they will still buy it even though they have to pay the more amount. They do not understand these all are the tricks that people can buy. Few times they mention that if you buy one, you will get one free, but the price is already included in that.
Okay, thank you very much.